All right, you two. Today we are going to play two decks. We're going to play LSV's red white deck, and we're going to play Is It Drake's? We're going to start with this Drake deck. So this is just Yuya's list from the last PT. There was one that went 10 out, but I didn't find it. I was like, I didn't look that hard, but I also just wanted to try Yuya's deck. So oh no, we're not playing modern with our Drake's deck. That's probably not going to go over well. Do you imagine if this Drake's deck played against the Thalia? Like, that would not be good. Put this up here. I like the look of this Drake deck. This is like the only deck in standard that I have not tried yet. Hey, Nameless, how are you doing? This deck probably looks like it's not very good against the white decks, but you do have Melody to steal creatures to block, Murmuring Mystic, Niv, Beacon Bolt, like just some removal. So, looks like after sideboard, there's eight removal spells. I'm good. Good, just waking up. Move my mic over here so I can be a little more quiet because my wife is still sleeping. Played Death Shadow at Regionals this weekend, Nameless. I lost the first round and then rattled off five in a row and lost two more. It was just like, ugh. We'll keep this. Kind of sucks this land comes into play tapped, but opponents play Steam Vents too. Okay, so now we can at least get away with our second land coming into play untapped. And there's a chance that we don't want to. Oh, Rug. It's a Rug deck. So we're looking for a Phoenix, Cleansing Nova. So this is like some weird control deck. Maybe this is like a Lich's Mastery deck or something. I don't think we want this. Put this on the bottom. So we found a Crackling Drake. I want to save this radical idea for when we go off. Don't think we're gonna need this shot. Did you play the PTQ yesterday? Nameless? All right, so it looks like we're playing a Nexus of Fate deck. If that's the case, we're looking at Teferi next turn. So I think we're just going to play this Enigma Drake so that if my opponent does play a Teferi, we can kill it. You didn't? Oh, I saw a guy tweet about that. Give me one second. Okay, no plays from our opponents. So let's start by Charter Coursing. Gonna ditch this Phoenix. We'll probably play this Guild Gate. I think I'm gonna Charter Course again because I would like to find like an Electromancer so that if they wrath my board, I can go nuts. They won just to lose the first round because they conceded. Conceded to a friend. Okay, so there's Electroboy. So let's ditch this Guild Gate. So next turn, we're going to be able to bring back our Phoenix if our opponent deals with this Enigma Drake. Have to worry about like not getting Settle the Wreckaged. This is a Chemist's Insight. Be right back. I just spilled some coffee. That Hardened Scales deck's really good. If my opponent doesn't play a Teferi, I think I'm just going to play a Crackling Drake. Draw a card. I kind of want to save this Electromancer for like an Electromancer, Radical Idea, Discovery. What are my opponents thinking about? Maybe like some funky Lynch's Mastery deck. Start by attacking. This deck doesn't have like the maximized velocity like combo aspect of it. Yeah, I see. I've seen you've been running the score up. We're going to ditch this land to the Radical Idea. An absolute savage. Death Shadow is good right now. I think it's like you play it anyways, and I play it anyways, but I think it's actually like well positioned. Like you just like there's a lot of good matchups. One of my opponents a Lich deck or like a or they have to be a Lich deck. Yeah, I think it's good. I think your only like bad matchups are like the Hardened Scales deck is not very good. I think you can beat, and then I think that like the Spirits decks can be kind of tough. But besides that, I mean, Humans is tough game one, but I think that Humans is not very good right now. So I think Shadow's just good. This is what I played at regionals. Nameless. And I was pretty happy with it. I really liked 74 of my 75 cards, and the only card that I wasn't super sold on, but was pretty good for me, was Jace. I played Jace against a company deck. Like, bounced a tracker, then untap, brainstorm, and cast 5 spells. And I was like, alright, this is sweet. Okay, so nothing from our opponent. So we're just going to attack, because even if we get Settle the Wreckage, we can play another Crackling Drake. I guess I could have gone for making this lethal, but I have a feeling we're going to get settled. Yeah, maybe I was supposed to go try to push some more damage, but I don't even really want to play another Drake. I should definitely, yeah, I messed up. I'm going to cast a Discovery just because I want to be able to next turn bring back 2 Phoenixes if my opponent wraps my board. Yeah, see, I messed up. Put into your graveyard. Put into your graveyard. All right, we're doing the shock. I'm going to do this one more time because I wouldn't mind hitting. Yeah, see, I should have gone. This is stupid. Like, I messed this all up. Yeah, see, I just, like, went full moron here. I should have at least made it so that these Drakes were lethal. 2-1. Creatures you control. Okay, so opponent's going to take another turn. Here comes the Lich. Yeah, because then they wouldn't be able to cast that. Yeah, I completely tossed this. No bueno. I should have just made it so that they had to do something and they couldn't just sit back and cast one of these. But what are you going to do? That PT Finals was, like, both people played really well. It was kind of a heartbreaker to see the game come down to that. Yeah, I should have forced my opponent to do something. But I don't know how. I don't know how this... All the licked cards in this deck. Like I was worried that I was going to get settled, but I had another Crackling Drake. Yeah. I messed this all up. Went full moron. I think this standard deck would be for you, Nameless. Like, I enjoyed this standard deck. It's like, it plays similarly to a shadow deck. Like, you see a lot of cards, you make a lot of decisions. So I'm kind of a fan of what this deck is doing. All right, so I'm going to wait for that Lich to get in play, and then I think I'm going to shock my opponent. Just kind of make them lose some resources, so this isn't going to flip. But I could have done it with this on the stack, but now we get Lich trigger. And they have to, like, probably exile two cards in the graveyard. We're going to yield again. They do have to deal with both of my creatures. I'm assuming this deck can never beat a Niv-Mizzet. So, like, after sideboard, we get Stroke, Spell Pierces. Probably Firemind's Research. Ral and Niv. I don't know if we'll bring in the Firemind's Researches. But I have no idea what this Lich's deck looks like. I know Ali and Trazi's been playing it at standard. Lich's Mastery. Let's figure out what is going on here. This Rainbow Lich by Ali. So three settles. Two fogs. Oh man, that gifts just draws them three cards. It's gas. Lyra, Carnage Tyrants, Nezahal. Okay, so they don't have enough mana to settle me, but they can fog me. They just scooped it up. All right. So we're cutting all of our removal. It doesn't appear like they play counter spells. They play some negates in their sideboard and duresses. So we want these. Want these. And want this for sure. I don't want my lava coils or my shocks. That means I can bring in maybe Ral and then the Fire Mines researchers are maybes. So let's see what this looks like here. I'm boarding out quite a few spells. So I think I'm gonna cut a Phoenix. I'm gonna cut an Electromancer. And I've only got six. And cards that can bring back Phoenix, I've only got 4, 8, 12, 16. I've only got 16 spells that can combo to bring back the Phoenix. I think it's important to still try to get under them, but this Fire Mines research has got to be pretty solid. If we can see one of these like pretty early. So I'll keep in three Phoenixes. Give this a whirl. This card is going to be pretty solid against the white weenie decks. This is my Ring Mystic. Yeah, this hand's pretty good. I think we're gonna go. Probably gonna untap because we want to be able to spell pierce a search for his Kanta. And then I've got to think. I might not play the Electromancer because I kind of want to. Yeah, that disguises it pretty well. I don't think I'm going to play the Electromancer because I would like to be able to hit a Gift of Paradise here. And I can still opt. Because I'm going to guess that this deck kind of struggles a little bit with mana. Well, now I want to hit a land drop. So let's go chart. Okay, we found a land. I am going to ditch. Probably this Enigma Drake. I think I had Spell Pierces. Hopefully that Spell Pierce does work for me. Because like this deck's mana base looks suspect to say the least. All right, we'll yield through. We'll opt for a land, probably. Not that land. All right, that's the land we want. I love Crackling Drake. Yep, revitalize, yield through this turn. All right. So if we find a land, we can bring a Drake back, and they can't settle me. So let's go for that. We're going to bring a Phoenix back, excuse me. Uh-oh. Hopefully there's a land. The wrong land. Sad. Turn to the dark side. Where's your beloved fog? Oh, I don't want to talk about it. Oh, there were 9 fog decks at the Pro Tour. A couple of them made the 6-4 list. I saw that. So they still can't settle the Wreckage Me, which is worth noting here. So we're going to try for... We had to decide if we want to try to get a Drake back. No, they can tempt my Drake. So One, two. I think it's better to just like play a crackling Drake and then hold up. Okay, so we're gonna be able to get out of Phoenix back next turn. And I can even cast this. I guess I can actually cast this right now. Because I can go one, two, three, and play a Drake next turn and still cast this. So let's just go like this. Don't think. Yeah, so we're just gonna do this again. All right, we want this stroke. You want your PTQ? Nice. This deck seems pretty good. Okay, so we're just getting contempted. Right. Get rid of this. Get rid of. Oh, just the steam vents. Now we get our Phoenix back. And then we play an Enigma Drake with Disdainful Stroke up. That's probably the game. This deck struggles against the aggressive decks, right? Freed Mania. I'm playing Yuya's List from the PT. I'm sure the maximized velocity version, like with more of those, is probably better against the white aggressive decks where you can just like combo kill somebody. Divination, you got it. I have this standard wheel on my chalkboard where it starts with like Chain Whirler decks get beat by Branch Worker decks. Branch Walker decks lose to Teferi decks and Drake's decks. Drake decks beat Teferi decks. Odonto decks beat Drake decks and Teferi decks. And then somewhere, Chance for Glory. Okay. Heal through this turn. Then the Chain Whirler decks beat like the green white tokens deck and the Odonto decks. So I'm trying to figure out which deck I want to play for the Invitational. But for now, I think as of right now, if I was going to play a tournament today, I would play a Chain Whirler deck. I think that's, but for right now, I think that's where we are. Yeah, the Boros decks, I imagine, are tough matchups, but no one was playing them. Yeah. This deck beats the mid-range decks and the control decks. Probably loses to the Odonto decks and the Chain Whirler decks. I found. Do you play. Now I want to ask you about this card here. I think this card is like kind of hot garbage. I think these Rals aren't very good. What do you think about Ral? Like, Chain Whirler decks lose to Grappling and Green White Tokens. So I think that's the other way around. I think that the Chain Whirler decks kind of beat up on the Green White Tokens decks. Because, like, they just like. I was playing a version with Banalish Marshall last night. And they just have enough removal after sideboard and Chain Whirler to just like punish your token draws so much. And you don't have enough removal. I'm assuming this is for like the Odonto decks. I think this could be like Chemist's Insight. It'd be more, might just be better, but I don't know. This card seems nice. Then I don't know if this is too many of this card. Two Mystics for gas, okay. Now, I kind of want to play more, like one more maximized velocity, though, I think. Right, I would like to play first. I would like to. Mulligan. Ugh. I played too far. I wish there were Sarkins. If I was able to find any, okay. I really want to keep this hand because I don't want to have to find lands plus enablers. I'm going to keep it. And, like, we have radical ideas and stuff to be able to pitch some of these to. Electromancer. I don't think this is what we want. But I'm not sure. I'm going to do this because I don't really know exactly what we're looking for. So I don't really want to opt at the moment. I played Pascal's List with the Mox, but changed the sideboard. Okay. Commune with the Dinosaurs. Oh, I've seen this deck. I feel like we're going to beat this deck. Because this deck doesn't have a lot of removal. If we can figure out how to go in here. This list has too many creatures. How dare you say such negative things about critters. Heal through this turn. Heal until next step. I feel like I want one more maximized velocity after playing a couple games with this deck. I do like how they've only got three of this, and I like how they have a lot of lava coils. Alright, we're just gonna run this Teddy Drakeskis out. Alright, chart turns some of our lands into legitimate spells. Ripjaw Raptor is kind of annoying. The finals I got to Drake, maximize velocity against Jeskai 21, you kind of feel. Yeah, so that's why I want to play one more maximize. So let's turn some of these lands into spells. And start to figure out if I can race this Ripjaw Raptor. I really don't want to lava coil this thing because that's just not really where I want to be. All right. Put into your graveyard. Probably keep this on top. I think we can race this. It's going to suck if, like, a whatever comes down, like a Regisaur Alpha. But we can lava coil it and still keep pumping this. Yeah, so, I want one more of those. And maybe I'll cut, like, Savage. And my opponent gets to draw a card. Yield through this turn. Probably can't win now. That's because we're gonna end up double lava coiling this thing. Deafening Clarion to give it lifelink. Nice. They shouldn't have dealt damage to it. I'm gonna hurl if I have to double lava coil this thing. Just absolutely hurl. Put into your graveyard. What you think? All right, I can buy that. I haven't played too much of this. I'm gonna play this Drake. And then we go bang bang. Next turn, crack. They draw two cards. We crack for 7/9. Oh my god, I have another Savage Style. Jeez. Into a Reggie. All right, we'll take that. All right. I shouldn't have played that land. I could have, like, dealt with this Ripjaw Raptor, but that's not actually going to win me the game. Another Reggie's not going to win me the game either. All right, we're good. We're good. I concede. So I've got to think that the Arclight Phoenixes are good against this deck. Like, I'd probably want to be, like, as combo-y as possible. They got main deck Immortal Suns, okay. And Rurik Almasar, what the hell does that thing do? So if I want everything that says kill a creature, Entrancing Melody is probably nice. Then Ral is probably nice. But I might just want to go, like, linear and go way over the top of their head. Like, I almost don't even want these shocks. These shocks only hit Llanowar Elf and my opponent. I feel like having four of these isn't very good. Stroke is the best. Oh, yeah, Stroke's very good against them. You're right. Maybe I don't need all of these or any of these because this is only good if I have a Electromancer. Having four Electromancers seems kind of weak. Something this deck doesn't do that I kind of wish it did was, like, Niv plus Dive Down. I don't know if I'm supposed to go, like, control-y. Or if I'm just supposed to, like, try to, like, maximize velocity and just go, like, hyper drakes. Because, like, if you want to go super control-y, you could literally just cut these Phoenixes, bring in this and this, do the old switcheroo, but I don't know how good that is. Because, like, a 3-2 in the air might not, like, actually win me the game. But, like, they don't really have a good way to deal with Niv. Niv has got to be good against them. I try to Mystic out. If they don't have Trample, they can't race against you. I want to bring in... I think my gut tells me I want to bring in the Niv. I think the Niv is better than Ral. Because they both kind of get a little grindy, and then Niv kills them. I don't think this card's very good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21. I'm going to cut these Electromancers on the draw, I think. Because of Savage Stomp, but we'll keep them on the play. I did not. Let me pull it up here. I saw Dylan Donegan's. You know, there was a deck that was... The copy of my 75, I posted a sideboard article from it. I saw a deck guide, and it won a regionals. The guy tweeted at me. Modern Challenge, Grixis Death Shadow from DeFish. One Lightning Bolt, Senior Version, something else. Two Surgicals in the main deck. That guy wants to get them. What'd he cut? He just went a little lower on removal and bobbles. That kind of makes sense. I hate Young Pyromancer. Not a Young Pyromancer fan. All right, we'll keep this. A little slow, but we can filter out some of these lands. This is where Shock would be nice, like right here, but I don't think Shock's going to be there. He's sideboard deprived. I didn't even see that. Put into your graveyard. Let's try this on top. Let's get our murmuring boy going. So we're gonna play a 2/4 Drake, and then we can choose. We're probably gonna play Mystic. Deathgorge Scavenger. That's annoying. Actually, that doesn't do anything against my Crackling Drake. It does do something against Enigma Drake. Let's hope we don't get Savage Stomped. Yeah, there's two deprives there. Ripjaw. This is the problem with this Murmuring Mystic. This Enrage card just beats the tar out of it. But it is going to brick wall this Deathgorge Scavenger. Alright, so we're going to go nuts next turn. Maybe I should have kept in some shocks. I'll keep in shocks on the draw. Now that I'll cut my Electromancers. Maybe a couple more of the other guys. Another Ripjaw. Okay. Let's just pass. And then we'll go nuts. And then we can untap a Niv. Alright, so let's get before we get to attacks. Yeah, this doesn't look super great here, but so I can just block, take four, they draw a card. Or I could just throw everything in front of one of these Ripjaw Raptors, which I think I'm going to do. I think we just need to, like, get one of these out of the way. We can't just take eight. Two. Yeah. Then we'll untap. We'll play Niv. Because we're going to have to deal with these. Thunderherd, Rurik Amasar. What did that guy do? Whenever inactivated, you may draw a card. Okay. So we only have two cards left. So yeah, let's just go to six. And then we get to smack that Llanowar Elves next turn. Blue. We actually get to smack the Llanowar Elves on their turn. No, it's whenever you draw a card. Let's just keep everything back. Okay, there's Reggie. If we untap with this Niv, we should win. Gas. All right, let's start here. Wow, dude, Niv is nice. Let's get rid of this. Always healed. You always like to deprive in the sideboard? It's nice to draw another Niv because it interacts in combat pretty well. If I play a land this turn, I don't think I've played a land. No. So let's go Crackling Drake. And let's go after. Reggie's going to draw 1, 2, 3. Now let's just get this dinosaur out of here. Let's discard. Just discard an Electromancer. I want another Niv in case things go completely wrong. So now if I go Crackling Drake plus it's 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 6 cards in exile, so 6, 11. It's not quite enough to kill my opponent. Even if we just deal them 2 damage. So if we deal them 2 damage, that's 16. 6, this is 8. 13, 14, 15. I don't think we can actually encounter anything. Yeah. Depends on how your board plan is. If you went all face, you would have won this turn. Probably, now that I think about it. And that's just like a deck thing that I don't know. So do I just like not attack and try to kill them next turn? Shock. It maximizes velocity, puts them to 16, makes this 8, 13, 14, 15. So we're one off. What a tilt. At least this deck, yeah. Yeah, so like I'm just going to wait. I don't even think I'm going to attack. Because like the way I lose is getting like cheesed out in combat. I could get Banefired, but like if I like I can't beat Banefire if I attack or not. Ripjaw. Yeah. So now we just go here. Play Drake. Go here. Go here. So this is 15, 20. It's a lot. So let's just, I guess, start by attacking with this, this, this. I could cast more spells, but we'll wait till if something goes wrong, we can wait until after combat to figure out what we need to do with our spells. Okay. So I think on the draw, we want to bring in, have a little bit more removal. So, like, maybe we want these shocks. Because I'm going to assume that Electromancer is much worse than the draw. Our arc lights are better. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. I don't know if I want one more of these to cut this. But, like, this card gets better when we bring these in. I think we're just going to submit. I don't think I want all 4. Let's try this out. Yeah, I want one more. I think I want one more maximized velocity. The Murmuring Mystic was kind of cool. Like, it gave my opponent cards, but, like, the cards didn't matter. Yeah, I think we just go way over the top of what they're doing. As long as we don't be like main fired. Heater. Yep. We're gonna keep it. Land. We get three looks at a land. Draw step, this opt. It's nice there's no elf. Yield through this turn. And yield until next end step. It helped you eat a Ripjaw and invalidate this whole ground game. Yeah. Slow draw from the opponent. We're going to put this on the bottom. All right, nice. So now we're going to chart. I could have opted. I could have opted to hit a red source to be able to shock. All right. I really don't want my opponent to eat this Beacon Bolt with a Death Court Scavenger next turn. So I think I'm actually pretty okay tossing back this Drake. And if they want to eat the Drake, they can eat the Drake. Oh, 2/5. Huge. I don't think we're going to be able to shock anything next turn. So let's just put this. And then let's yield until next end step. Opt for something. Then we're going to play the old Murmuring Boy. I don't think we want this. Put on the bottom. Stroke's not bad. If I had something else to do with my mana, I would just hold Stroke. But I really don't want to just throw away 4 mana. Like if I had another land, I would go Drake plus Stroke. But I think we want to play Murmuring Mystic because it's just going to match up here. And it kind of helps us get rolling, even though my opponent can, you know, get free reign. Like if we untap with this, we should be in good shape. It appears we are going to untap this. I'm not going to block. Like my opponent might punk me for 2 damage here, but... Always yield. So if I can keep this in play, I'm pretty happy. I'm gonna attack with it too, because we're not blocking. Blocking these 4 chumps. Dude, this Murmuring Mystic is nice. I'm a big fan. I'm going to go over. Let me just go back over here just while I have the thoughts in my head. PT, is it Drake's? Cards, maximize. Just while I have the thoughts going on here. See if a screw off red or have settle. Maybe. I want to protect this Beacon Bolt. So I'm just going to. I think we're just going to play it slow. Because like next turn we'll play Drake and have Stroke up. And if they go to Disdainful Stroke this, or they go to settle this, I'm going to Disdainful Stroke. Because I think that this Murmuring Mystic is just going to be too important as the game goes on. Okay, taking 2 from this thing. And this is 4. I would like some Niv dive down action, I think, in the sideboard.
This is a Carnage tournament. I'm gonna feel stupid. It's a fucking Carnage tournament. God damn it. Okay. So we can go maximize velocity this to trade here, or we can shock them. I think we're okay with just holding back here. Because we can just go hit here to trade. Another Carny boy, okay. It's going to be a tough card to beat. Shoot. This is not an instant. Yeah, it's a sorcery. Just figured that out. So yeah, we gotta let this go. So maybe I played this too passively. Now I'm gonna block this. Probably should have put one more in front of there to kill it, but I think I'm going to shock my opponent at the end of the turn. Now I need like a Drake. So I can bolt this. Fucking Carnage Shiner is just gonna wreck me. I need to block 15 power. There's 15 power coming in. And I need to stop 8 of it. 4, 5, 6. Yeah, I can do it. Isn't this some insane time for you to be up here? It's just, it's 8 in the morning, Ben. Nice job in the PTQ. I mean, 7-2 is pretty good, right? Yeah, what time is it for you, Ben? It's perfect time for bacon. So I need to make it so that I can somehow magically rip a Drake next turn and kill my opponent. That's what we're doing. Need to stop 9, yes. Yeah, you're right. You're right. I miscounted. So so 5, 6, 7, 8. I need to cast one more spell while having dealing 17 damage, which just isn't going to happen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can deal 2 points to them. I can't even like kill this one of these Carnage Tyrants. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fucking Carnage Tyrant, man. I think I got too comfortable. I didn't play this game as aggressively as I should have. Shock our opponents. Too bad. I mean, there was probably a way to make it so we could have maybe knocked off one of these Carny boys. But I think we're drawing dead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We don't have something to give us double strike. Now that the Murmuring Mystic's dead, we can't block profitably. Oh, I'm still just dead anyways. Derp. I need to move my stuff over. They're just zoned out. The struggle. So let's see what we would have drawn. I wonder if it was wrong. I probably needed to be more aggressive. I didn't think about Carnage Tyrant. And Carnage Tyrant's a card that if you don't... They were not good. They were not good. They were not good at all.
Ugh. Need the second cup of coffee. Or third, I don't know.
Maybe we'll grab some more. I'll be right back. No bueno. I usually beat green black, but they have weird draws where you do nothing, just play a Carnage Tyrant. Yeah, so you can't go like super grindy, I guess, because you do just get Carnage Tyrant. That makes me want to play like these just seem horrible. The Niv-Mizzets, or no, the Rals. All right, I'm going to keep this hand. We have two threats. It's a little slow, but we can discovery next turn. Like, we can curve out Drake. Okay. Flower. So, playing against green-white. Shock's not bad. I'm assuming at some point Shock is going to be very good for them. I don't think I want either of these. I don't think two shocks is what we want. Now, hopefully they don't give us play like a Mara here. Adanto, okay. The nice thing about Adanto is like, this just blocks it. And they like can't really gain a lot of, life dealing with it. They can't like protect it. Alright, that's nice. So now I kinda wanna try to just kill them out of nowhere. So like I can do two, hit this. This is effectively 4, 6, 4, 5, 6. So hang on. 4 damage, 16, 14. Next turn, play this. These are both 4s. Maximize velocity makes these 5 plus 1. So I can't kill them. I can't kill them over 2 turns. Yeah, so we're going to play the Drake. There's a chance we kill them next turn, though. Because next turn we just go like velocity. We don't have triple red, which isn't good. But we can go like velocity on something, shock, radical idea. You can't even lava coil. No, not quite. Took me a second to get there, but just making sure. Conclave Tribunal. All right. So that's probably going to take my Crackling Drake. So we can go like full control here and still keep hitting them like Shock, Lava Coil. Because like now I just want to hit this, Shock this. I guess I can cast this first and still be able to do my plan. an opt. Yeah, I kind of just want to, like, not get whacked by this history for six next turn while, like, fiving my opponent. And then we have, like, opt plus maximize velocity next turn. So, like, we theoretically, we could kill our opponent. We need to draw a red source. So if we draw another Enigma Drake, we could kill our opponent next turn. And it's like, even though we lose a little bit of value, we do get to just smack them. Amara, okay? While not, we have to play offense and defense pretty well there. So now we are looking for opt. Probably put this on top. It cuts off Enigma Drake. It cuts off Crackling Drake as an out, but I think it's just another spell. So let's just go here. And that does it. Game. That's why I think I want two of these. Because, like, this kind of deck is going to put pressure on you, but you can just go over the top with your Drakes. Which I'm a big fan of. We have assembled Splinter Twin. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Okay. So against this deck, I think I want Murmuring Mystic. Probably want Spell Pierce. That's kind of it. Beacon Bolt's kind of... Well, Beacon Bolt hits Lyra. So that might be okay. Niv's just, like... Niv's going to take the game over. I want all my removal. Entrancing Melody takes creatures. It's Tribunal, March, and Angels. But we have, like, approximately seven cards to ban.
Morning.
So probably cut Arclight Phoenixes. Because, like, we're bringing in three reactive spells and a more expensive one. I assume Electromancer is pretty good because they just have to be able to deal with it or I'm going to go nuts. Maybe this isn't good. Maybe Spell Pierce isn't good. It's my worst, like, radical idea. I've got two cards. Is Niv bad? I don't think Niv's bad. Spell Pierce is pretty sweet on the draw. I got two more radical ideas. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. What if I go like this and this? Let's try this out. We're going to go like this.
I think on the play, I want both of my Electromancers.
But I don't really know. Well, we got a mulligan this. If we had two lands, this hand would be decent, but we don't. This has no lands. All right, this is lands. I'm assuming Electromancer. Electromancer is going to be good. You only ever want. That's what I'm thinking. Like when I was working on this deck over here, I cut one for another maximize. It's not bad. I want to play 8 Drakes and then 4 Electro and then 3 Electromancers. History of Benalia. So we just have to survive. That's where we are right now. That's not bad. I should have gone Shock Attack. That was stupid. I still think I'm going to go Shock Attack. Because if I just keep playing spells, and like Shock's not going to do too much against this deck, maybe I should have boarded out some Shocks. Through this turn. There's also a chance I should have held Shock to be able to like Phoenix out. Okay. Because like it's going to be much harder to get a Phoenix back with where we are. And now we can set up Crackling Drake plus. Kind of sucks we can't block. We're not going to be able to block these two. Keeps history in check. Okay. I'm going to attack because I'm not going to block. And at this point, if they want to trade Electromancer so I don't take 8 damage, I'm okay with it. Yeah, this is all right. Because like, I'm not blocking here. I find it interesting Yuya didn't play any fiery cannonades. A Johnny. Gross. So I'll take 5, 9. I can't kill this, so we're gonna go like here. I had 2 candidate KY you'd ever want. It's a better answer to a Danto, maybe. I think we're beyond the point of Disdainful Stroke being where we wanna be. Kill this. Block one of these, take 5, 9. Yeah, we have to suicide both of our creatures in blocks. We're just not gonna recover. Like we only trade with one, we're just not gonna recover from that. Dude, freaking history, man. How do I board be more aggressive? I don't think I want these Disdainful Strokes. They just like rot in my hand. 2 mana take a token. That seems so loose. Looks like my stream is tweaking out here. Yeah, it looks like we're having a little bit of technical difficulties. Oh, no. I think we're back. Then maybe I just want to keep, like, bring these art lights back in, cut this Murmuring Mystic, and just be, like, really aggressive on the play. Try to turn into, like, just try to combo them out. That's why I want a second Maximize Velocity, because it's just going to help so much better with comboing. going to try this. Just try to, on the play, just go nuts. Just go Ham Nation. Free stream is still going decent. Computer's just lagging up a little bit. I would like to play first. Forgot to log into my Streamlabs. So we have a shock. We've got a radical idea. I think I'm going to keep this hand, though. It might be, I don't know if I'm supposed to keep hands like this, but I think I'm going to. Because, like, this radical idea can turn these, this land into something, and we just get to see so many cards here. And this is kind of like a get out of jail button, get out of jail free card here. I don't think I'd keep this hand if I was on the draw. Discovery. Okay. I think I want both of these. But I want the Enigma Drake first. Okay, there's our Odonto Boy. So if my opponent uses their entire turn to Conclave Tribunal this Enigma Drake, I'm all right with that. I'll get Historic. So now we're going to play Electromancer, Radical Idea, and Shock. Well, now we're probably not going to Radical Idea. So let's play this. And we're just going to start hammering them. Into your graveyard. I think I'm gonna put this into my graveyard too. No, it might be two cards next turn. Actually, it can be two cards this turn. We can not even worry about a history token. Yeah, I like that. So let's just attack, chart, draw two, and then try to set up a big turn next turn. Okay. So now we can go like Drake, Shock, Radical Idea next turn. And then crack for five. Okay. So this probably takes Drake, if I had to assume. We're going to get cracked for five. Then we have another blocker next turn. I know, I should have just shot one of those and cracked for two. That was stupid. I just missed 2 points of damage. I'm not blocking with this Electromancer. Oh, that was dumb. Yeah, because I'm going to do it anyways. That was stupid. If we lose, if we miss out on 2 points of damage, we lose by two. I deserve that. I deserve that for sure. I'm going to block this Odonto. Or just take four. That's all right, too. Yeah, that was stupid. So I'm going to just fire this off end of turn because we don't have a Phoenix. If we had a Phoenix in the graveyard, I might wait to untap. But alas, we do not. Yeah, we missed out 2 points. It's stupid. Null Hide Ferox. Okay. That's a big boy. need some gas. That's not gas. All right. Put on top. We still haven't played a land. Put on top. So if I attack my opponent and shock them, block. 6, they go to 10. Hey, Phil. I think we're going to shock this, because that's 7. They go to 9, shock them next turn, they're dead. Phil, stop. Why would I shock the Vanguard? Oh, because they might take a bunch of damage. They can't cast non-creature spells, which is important. I'm a little worried about Alira, but I don't think we're really beating that. So let's just see if we can deal with this. You want to play 4 life, bud? I like your idea there. Stop. Behave. Phil's being a little jerk this morning.
Aren't you?
You're awful cute, but you can be a jerk. Okay, so now let's just get in here. They can't like Conclave Tribunal this, so I think it's like Lyra or Bust. Well, we kill the token. Oh, you'd have gone full control mode. Okay, that makes sense. I was just gonna like not do anything because and just take this. This is 8. Just so that if I hit Lava Coil, Knight of Autumn. Okay, that's a problem. They gain 4 life. Okay. So 13. So they go to 11. This is 8. All right, let's untap. So I'm just going to shock this knight and attack them. If they were at 2 less damage, they'd be dead here. Just for the record. Again, they can't cast non-creature spells. So unless they have a Lyra in their hand, I don't know how they make it through next turn. I'll probably just hit the knight. Yeah, they're at 2 less life, they'd be dead. Or would they be dead? 7. This knight. No, they wouldn't be exactly dead. Cause... And now we block this, take 2. So they need like a Lyra or another knight and us to not draw a spell. Basically. If they had another knight and we'd attack that one turn, we'd be good. Mulhive Ferrix loses all abilities until end of turn. Okay. Is this a Conclave Tribunal? Yep. It's good. We're making all sorts of muff-ups here. That's what's happening. Niv? Wow. Was that a good draw step? We were rewarded for our punt. Because they couldn't cast. They have to get rid of the text on it. I'm not gonna attack. I guess I actually should attack because this block's here. If they draw land, they go pay. No, I shouldn't attack. Because they go pay, then convoke, and then attack me. We're still like dead in the water, Lyra. We're just gonna go chump, whack. I definitely messed up by not doing that play that Free Mania was talking about earlier. I get confused with that. I played a little Nullhide Ferox last night, and I was confused that you could get rid of its ability on its own. And they scooped it up. I think we were lucky to win that one. Pretty lucky. But I think if we'd have had our head on straight, we would have won that, because I missed out on two points of damage, which could have mattered. I played zero standard. Though the problem is like, am I supposed to look to play a long game against this deck? I'm going to go say hi to my wife. I'll be right back. Sorry, I was just going to chit-chat with my wife. Yeah, we'll keep this hand. We have an Electromancer with a lot of stuff going on. I like how Electromancer synergizes with the chart, of course. Like, sometimes if you want to go, like, a little more grindy plan, it's nice. Yield through. No, I'll yield through this turn. Esper. I feel like this matchup's going to be a little harder because of Vraska's Contempt. Do not want a shock. Drew a shock. There's a chance. There's an argument to not playing that because it plays into Syncopate or their mana this turn. Yeah, maybe that was loose. Maybe that was loose. I don't really want to play into Syncopate, but I'm all right with it if they decide to counter this Charter Course. So I'm going to play this, and then play this tapped, and then next turn on their Insight turn, look to jam a Drake. Yeah. Because I want to give them something worth countering here. Okay. We're going to be sad boys if we get Teferi here. Put a card on top. Okay, we're not going to get Teferi. Land. Tilt. Put into your graveyard. Put on top. Kind of sucks. Like, again, we couldn't play into there because we didn't hit a land to get to Insight, which kind of sucks. If they play a Teferi, I think I'm going to shock it. No, now I'm not going to shock it. Turn off auto yields. Shoot. Should have radical idea. I kind of want to hold. But then they get to flashback their Insight. So we're not going to do that. Make them counter this or kill it. Or deal with it on their turn. Oh, the scatter's sick. Didn't think about scatter. Yeah, that was a little loosey-goosey. They ditched the land, okay. Yield until next end step. 1, 2, 3, 4. So then I go Teferi. Gross. Okay. I think I'm going to opt. Because I need to find a way to deal with this Teferi. Or, like, an Arclight Phoenix. Because, like, Teferi in play for multiple turns is no bueno. Jeez. So, if we get a Phoenix, we can still figure something out here. I'm gonna do this in response just to make him think about something. I think we're fishing for something here. If that's a reason to keep going with our stuff, not wait, because we could have tapped out and played that. Ditch the steam vents. Yield until next step. The old Teferi. So what do we bring in against them? We're going to bring in Firemind's Research, Ral, Niv, and the counter spells and Murmuring Mystic. So we're actually going to bring a lot in. Well, there's a Drake. And I don't think this deck plays sweepers that hit Crackling Drake, so we're just gonna jam. Cast down. Come on, we need. You like play Electromancer, Radical Idea into a Drake, Shock, Shock, bring it back, and then hope that works, which it's not gonna work. They have seven cards in hand. I should have played an Electromancer. Should have let off of that. We're going to go one more set here. Because as soon as I ultimate this, I'm good. Yield until next end step. The hero, man. The hero is going to get us. Should I play like, yeah, if I play Electromancer first, I'm ahead. Much more going on. I feel like we have some pretty solid inevitability. As long as we don't get this doesn't get emblemed. Just because, like, the Phoenix package is so good here. Yield until next end step. We're out of crackling. All right, let's go and bring a Phoenix back. Attack Teferi. And then I'm just going to shock play Enigma Drake. Yeah. And now we're. If they counter this, we're gonna scoop it up here. Wow. I mean, they probably have another. I guess, how many contempts are they through? One. I guess I only threw two contempts. Alright, ritual suit. I yield. I yield, opponent. I had to figure out a sideboard here. So, cards that are not good. Lava Coil, no bueno. Shock, no bueno. We'll start there. Cards that are good. We have 11 good cards. Or by converted mana cost. We got 4, 8, 12, 16. We have 16 ways to bring back our Light Phoenix, which is a little low. So let's trim one of these. And maybe one more Electromancer. Electromancer is just not that good. I think we can win like a straight up game. If we don't have to Electromancer go ham. I think. Not sure. But though Electromancer does work a lot really well with Charter Course after board. I'm gonna go with Opt. Is Opt worse than Radical Idea? Probably is. Kind of want all my radical ideas to be able to pitch lands. I could just cut a land. Is that crazy? Like, is it dumb to go like this? It's probably dumb. I'll try it on the draw. I'll grab some more coffee. I kind of wish that these Rals were like Chemist's Insights. Gross. Alright. Still kind of gross. I'm going to put that on top where I need lands. I'm just going to play the Electromancer next turn. I doubt they're going to leave in Ritual Set, and Electromancer is at least going to put some pressure on them. If we draw a Charter Course, like I'm definitely going to discover. I think I'm going to Discovery before I attack, because if I hit a Charter Course, it's just so good. Or they're just going to Moment of Craving this bad boy as a search for his Kanto. Maybe it makes sense if it was a search, right? Now I'm just going to play Drake. We can always try to keep one ahead of the ball when it comes to having a threat in play. I only play 20 lands. You can't do so much hand with a lot of lands. So maybe it was right to ditch a land. I'm definitely going to do it on the draw. Thought Erasure. But Thought Erasure is not very good. It does take a Drake. Discovery. Oh, sweet. Put on top. Then we just crack in for one, and we're going to draw two cards. Then we can threaten it again next turn. We can ditch a land if we need to, though. That's double red for our Crackling Drake. This might be some contempt action. Yep. Nice. So we could be in a little trouble here if my opponent goes like Teferi tick down on this. Charter Course is so good if we hit a creature, but it's not very good if we don't hit a creature. So I'm gonna put this in the graveyard. Okay. No Teferi take down. Don't Teferi me, dude. You bastard. I wonder if he ticks up. Nope. Oh, sorry, we can get it back. I did not play a land. You were right about that. Let's ditch this. It's gonna be tough to grind this thing out. Grind this deck out here. Yield until next end step. I think I'm going to put this on top because it's just a cheap way to get another. Always yield. If I kept one, I might as well keep the other one. On the bottom. All right, so there's our boy. I think we're just going to pass, draw a card off this research. Because we're going to play Niv next turn. Niv's going to trade with Teferi more than likely. Yeah, I feel like I want, instead of the Niv, instead of the whatever it is, the Rouse. I kind of want like Niv plus Dive Down or like Invoke the Divine. OP saw this coming. Now we can just jam Niv here or we can go like Charter Course plus Radical Idea. Because like the problem with just jamming Niv, I don't really want to play Niv, because if I just play Niv, I can just bring back this Arclight Phoenix. I would like to be able to play Niv and do something with it. I do need to not ditch this last defense, though. Jeez. Attack Teferi. Does this work? Does this work? It does not work. I don't know if I'm supposed to just jam Niv or not. Something like an opt would be kind of nice here. You can't champion for. Well, we're gonna do it now because we have two. Because he can just go Teferi, tuck it. But at least he's not drawing a card with Teferi. And then we can just play another Niv. Hopefully draw a spell. Draw a card. Wow. That seems bold. I guess if they tuck it, then I opt. Ixalan's Binding. Yep. We're dead. We are dead. Okay. Let's get the last match in here. But while I have my idea here. Man, we got beat up there. That did not feel good. Let me go back here. Let me just go back to the deck list quickly. I think it's like a little silly to not have dive downs. Yeah, I agree. I agree it's not very good, but. We don't want. I believe we wanted another Murmuring Mystic. The problem with Murmuring Mystic. We're gonna get back for the last match. I just want to do this while I'm thinking. How do you spell it? M-U-R. U-R. M-U-R. Probably not today, no. Murmuring Mystic. I don't think three of these is what we need. The problem with Fiery Cannonade is I think Murmuring Mystic is likely better than Fiery Cannonade, but Murmuring Mystic does not play well with Fiery Cannonade. I'm just going to get this in here before I forget. Fiery Confluence, Fiery Justice, Fiery Cannonade. And then if I'm playing Electromancer, I just want like a... I want like one of these. Maybe move this over here. I kind of actually kind of like the removal. Just kind of bouncing ideas off my brain for right now. I just want to get it on paper before I forget. So let's play our last match. So I think this right here, this match is a match we could have won that I just lost to a Carnage Tyrant. I don't think we could have beat this deck here. This deck just kind of railroaded us. It's pretty soft on my end. If I get some confirmations, then I will go for it. Yeah, this hand's pretty solid. Like an opt, and then chart a course, ditch Phoenix. I haven't had a lot of nut Phoenix games, if we've noticed. So maybe I need to add like one more kind of Phoenix-y cantrip to my deck. Heal until next end step. Like, does anybody else notice that? We haven't Phoenixed yet. Okay, so we're playing. I think it's Boros. This is a Boros Guildgate, though. I want to put this on top because it's like a free card to ditch with my charts. Okay. Tormenting Voice. Gross. Yeah, so maybe like we just put pen to paper here while. Tormenting. Just kind of thinking here. Wow, I didn't play anything. So they can't play anything for instant speed here that kills this Enigma Drake. And I don't really want to play. I don't want to play Goblin Electromancer while it's favorable for them to kill it. If they want to take two cards to kill this Enigma Drake, then go for it. Another 5-0, nice. Okay, we'll take this. Because now it still feels a little bad, I guess, because they can just shock this thing. So next turn we go like this. This, we hit a red land. Then we're kind of doing stuff. Okay, Aurelia. That's kind of a tough one to beat. Ooh. So this is what? This is Trips Phoenix. Guess. I can even maximize, put this in the graveyard. I think we want a Crackling Drake. Because we can give it haste next turn. And we're going to maximize velocity this so that it can attack through. It gets our Phoenixes back and it makes so it can attack through Aurelia. Dude, all you have to do is whine. And then we got what we wanted. I think I'm just going to crash in here. I'm going to hit it in for 9. And then Crackling Drake is big next turn. A little worried about like a Baneslayer Angel. Okay, Lava Coil's okay. Give this haste. Probably ditch a Drake. Now, am I attacking? I don't think I'm attacking with a Phoenix. We're just getting in here for 7. Next turn, I can go Lava Coil something, opt, and still play Enigma Drake. Storm's a good deck. Like you're like the Death Shadow deck's pretty favored, but it's still just a solid deck. Deece. Yeah, nice. So hit this. I should have done all my cantrips first, I think. If we're gonna be above the rim. I was worried that they had like a shock or an instant speed. I don't know. I just thought like I thought Freed like I had such a good setup for next turn that I didn't have to worry about it. Okay. So this is like the Red White Angels deck. I don't have any idea how to sideboard against this deck. I kind of want to shave all of my cards here because they play Ixalan's Binding. The Boros Angels, yeah. Rao, yeah. That's what I'm thinking too. Rao is actually pretty nice. What if I just cut all my creatures? Let me just see what this looks like. And what if we just go like this? Just turn into like this blue-red Niv deck. Firemind hits all their creatures, which I don't know if that matters or not. Where... like this. Maybe have three Electromancers. I'm going to try like this. This might not be the right way to do this, but I'm going to try. Maybe do something a little more aggressive on the play. I don't know how good this is. I wonder if I'm supposed to mulligan this, because we have no way to put this in our graveyard, but we have, like, Electromancer. Electromancer's going to be pretty solid. Well, Shock, they have... don't they have a Danto? They've got... if it's, like, Brad Nelson's deck, they have a Danto. Like, it's the same reason that we keep it in against green-white, right? I don't even think I want to play Electromancer here. I think we're just going to search for a land. My opponent's not going to play something. I don't want to play something that gets shocked. Nice. We're going to do this so that we can play Electromancer. If my opponent goes to shock it, I can Radical Idea back an Arclight Phoenix. Tilt. This isn't even that bad if we miss here. Okay. We prefer not to, but if we do miss, we get to put an Arclight Phoenix in the graveyard. Okay, so they got a history come in here. Resplendent Angel, okay. So we can either go Electromancer, hit this, or we can go, well, now we can do it all. So let's go like this. I think we just want to trade, because then it's got a chance to make our Rao better. Though it's pretty bad. Yeah, it's not. It's pretty bad if they play like whatever the dumb card is. I can't think of the name of it. Like, if they play... gosh, I'm losing my train of thought. If they play Rekindling Phoenix. But there's an argument to just getting in while getting is good. But now if we hit a land... we just smoke this. And we're kind of all right smoking this tilt. on top. Put on top. Now we're just going to hold up stroke and shock. Like we can shock a history token, untap, row this. We could lava coil this, but I would rather just keep the board clear so that Ral hits this thing. This Ral's actually been is pretty nice right now. Makes me think that I want it. Yep. We're looking for a land. Let's just make our land drops. Let's just like get Niv in play. Though I do kind of want to bait out an Ixalan's Binding. I kind of want to play one Blink of an Eye in this deck because Blink of an Eye is a way to get out from, like, Ixalan's Binding is very good against this deck. And Blink is a nice way to get around that. I really don't want to jam. Like, I kind of just want to go chart a course, shock, shock, bring back two Phoenixes. Like, I really don't want to run this. I want this Niv to be, like, the last thing that in play. Or be able to play Niv and do something. I saw one less play, one Mystic, and one Blink, and one Mirage Conjecture. One less, yeah. I think Blink of an Eye is really important. That might be loose, but because it's like we could have gone Niv plus that. One, two. So I want like a dive down just because if I can like untap with this Niv, we're in just such good shape. Put in. Okay. So if we draw a land, now I'm going to go Niv plus Lava Coil. Opponent's run on empty. Yeah, so. Just get some, we got to get something out of this Niv. Radical Idea is going to keep us going. All right, so they had a binding. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Like, this Blink of an Eye would be solid because we don't have that many ways left to win. Our opponent is on MG. off. Should have left that in my hand. I'm going to not do anything because this lets us hold up Disdainful Stroke. And if they deal this Arclight Phoenix, we can find a way to bring it back. Like, that's the start of the next chain. Okay. So I think I left my Crackling Drakes in. Yeah. So Crackling Drake is a big draw here. Dude, sequencing cantrips for this deck is sweet. Okay. We have Beacon Bolt to deal with, like, whatever big scary thing my opponent plays. And we can even, like, if they play Rekindling Phoenix, we can Beacon Bolt it twice. Yeah. Yield until next end step. Yeah, we're just going to 1, 2, 1, 2. Yeah, we're going to hold this. So let's go like this. Put on the bottom. Then we'll Radical Idea, ditch this land. That'll bring back the Phoenix, and then we'll chart a course. Oh, I floated a red, but I didn't have to. Can't play that Niv, unfortunately. Oh, wow, wait, the Phoenix didn't come back? Didn't I cast Opt, Beacon Bolt? Oh, I cast Opt last turn. What a tilt. That's all right. We're going to be able to still chart a course. Here. Mirari's Conjecture is a cool way to go over the top. Okay. So next time we can go shock, bring back. We can't bring it back. We don't have enough, quite enough going on. Radical Idea wins the game. Never lucky. I'm not going to play the Mystic in case we play another game. Because, like, if they deal with Crackling Drake, I can go Bolt plus Electromancer or Shock. If we're going to get our 3-2, then I'm going to go get my wife some coffee, come back, make one more change to the deck. Okay. Be right back. Okay.